I'm trying to stay positive these days, which is, I believe, helpful for everyone. We all know there's enough negativity in the world, but staying positive is, I'm being helped in that by the fact that my dreams, I'm having this run of just incredibly positive dreams. I can't even explain how positive it is. I had a dream last night, several. I cannot quite explain. It escapes me somehow. But somehow, in every situation, I saw every situation was exactly the same. Applied exactly the same realization to all situations, and this was the dream I was having. Not only that, but I had this extraordinary dream of my cat, who passed away recently. And I asked this cat, I said, "Cat, you know what? I'd like you to be resurrected. Why don't you appear in a resurrected form for me?" I said, "If anyone can do it, you can do it." And lo and behold, last night in a dream, I was in a room, and in walked the cat. And I said in the dream, "Oh my God, you've come back from the dead. This is incredible." And the cat went around saying hello to everyone in the house. And we were all just like, "Whoa, you're back from the dead." And I was just, it was just a stunning dream. The cat was totally alive, totally healthy. Everything was exactly perfect, you know, with the cat. So this just like, it was such a wow dream, the way it presented itself. So I'm on a streak here of just stupendous positivity in terms of what's happening beneath the surface. Actually, this world is the dream. This, when you're awake, the state of what's called conscious state, that's actually the dream. It's a dream of determinacy. Reality is indeterminate, entirely indeterminate. That means, yes, it means that all situations, all conditions are indeterminate. There are no situations, there are no conditions for everyone. Grant everybody their unconditional, indeterminate freedom, and you yourself will begin to experience this as well. That means nobody is bound. There's no such thing as a situation. There's no such thing as a condition. Period. You see, and this cat coming back was showing me, look, I'm 100% alive. Subtle level, the cat. So this is the dream of determinacy. This is the dream. This is the delusion. When we're awake and going around, that's the delusion. Dreams are actually closer to truth than the waking, as we are awake in the day-to-day functioning state. That's the dream. That's why when we have these dreams of great clarity, and then I wake up in the morning, they seem to disappear, because we're back in this determinate belief system, which is false. So all of this momentum is working, and beneath the surface, just barely beneath the surface, that there's all these tremendous breakthroughs that I can't quite seem to explain at the moment. We'll see how it goes. It should clarify more. So don't give up on the spiritual path, the path of realization of truth. It's just maybe we need to get to the real heart of it, which is this indeterminate. All is totally indeterminate. There's no such thing as a determinate situation ever, as Longchenpa says, an unreleased situation, event cannot arise. An unreleased event. It's impossible for an unreleased event to arise. Totally impossible. And this is true. And there's within us, we know this truth. And so this truth is vibrant, you know, within me, except it seems to be clouded over during the daytime. Awake, but it's not really awake, it's asleep. The asleep condition of day-to-day life. This is the sleep. We go to sleep when we wake up from our sleep. The words are difficult to use here, right? But we can get around that. So we often, you know, dreams are so flexible and fluid, right? So indeterminate. And we wake up here, everything is so solid and determinate. And we think, oh, this is reality. No, it's not. This is the dream. This is the dream. So it's a matter of reversing those two, and we're taught that this, you have to know yourself in this world. We have to know the world, come to know the world. No, that's a dream. The determinate world that we look at seems to be a determinate world. That's a dream, and we think that we need to know how to function, you know, and grow into this. No, we don't. Not at all. Nothing is determinate. Nothing is determined. There's no one or any situation right this minute in the entire universe and universes that is determinate. Not one situation. None. Absolutely none. No exceptions to that. No exceptions. No exemptions. Pure, unequivocal fact. This is indeterminate. This is indeterminate. All is indeterminate. No conditions, no situations. No conditions, no situations. No conditions for anyone. No situations for anyone. Free everyone. No matter how terrible you may think they are, whatever, you just say, this too has no situation and no condition. This too is totally indeterminate. No exceptions, no exemptions, no exceptions, no exemptions. And this can become our realization. The delusion of determinancy, the clouds of delusion can part. In some cases, they have. And those here in this world know that it's all totally indeterminate. As Sri Ananda Mayama said, she saw absolutely no difference between the realm of the living and quote unquote the realm of the dead, the subtle realms. It was all one, you see. No differentiation whatsoever because it's all indeterminate. She did not see a determinate realm and an indeterminate realm. Two realms. No, it was all indeterminate. We can have that same vision. This is called true wakefulness. If all is indeterminate, there are no layers and levels. There's no life and afterlife realm. There's not two realms. No, it's all just one realm, one indeterminate realm. This is a fact, and this is what is surfacing here in my just beneath the surface here. And of course, we stay loyal to the egoic belief system here that we're all told that we need to, this is what we need in order to know how to function, supposedly, and that for success, you need to believe in determinacy for success. Well, no, you don't. What kind of success is that? It's hell. It's failure. What they're really teaching is failure. They say, here's what you need in order to fail. Well, gee, thanks, but no thanks. So I'm just praying that the clouds will part. I hope they will. They haven't parted yet as far as, you know, true wakefulness is concerned. There's still this dichotomy between the wakefulness and the egoic belief system that everybody thinks that they need to adopt as their, you know, as truth, even though it's falsity. So the best we can do is to keep trying. The great ones before us have said, you can do this. We're helping you, we're encouraging you. This is truth, not opinion. This is truth. Truth is true. Truth is not an opinion. We don't have to dwell in the realm of opinions. We don't have to go along with this culture of lack of attainment, this dualistic culture, this culture that believes in determinism and tells us that this is the way we must function. No. Release it all from any belief that it's determinate. released from all conditions and all situations. There are no conditions, there are no situations. There are no conditions, there are no situations. And abide in the inherent greatness of reality. Reality doesn't need conditions or situations. There are none. We think that we need the determinacy to feel great. No, it's just the opposite. Reality is inherently great. Reality is inherently great just the way that it is. It cannot be changed. So when you realize there are no conditions or situations, that means there's no death either. There's no sickness, there's no death. You're releasing everybody from all of that. And since reality is inherently great and inherently happy, when you release all your valuing of conditions and situations, you don't fall into some void or unhappiness or something. No, it's bliss. It's bliss. Effortless bliss. It's not based on any belief in conditions or determinacy whatsoever. Uncaused. Not the result of any process. So this is the best I can say to talk about it, but beneath the surface there's this experiencing of it in dreams. I don't know, it's been maybe a week now of just these super, super positive dreams that just... And I don't struggle. In fact, I can't remember exactly what they are. I don't struggle with it. I just keep working because I know the work is paying off. If I can't remember the dream or how to explain it, that's okay. Don't struggle with the struggle. There are no conditions. There are no situations whatsoever. And this too is indeterminate. This too is entirely indeterminate. All is perfectly indeterminate. So in spite of seeming, lack of culture of attainment here in this world, which most certainly the culture of attainment is like almost virtually extinct, what we're talking about here is not something that you can talk about in general in the world. Nobody has any idea what you're talking about. But in spite of all that, we still can awaken from our dream of determinacy. And those who are on the path must continue on the path and must continue to allow this reality, this truth to surface. So, there's no excuses. We can't make excuses like, well, the world is against us and there's all these troubles. You can't be an excuse maker on the path. You just have to say, wow, okay, the dream is the dream of determinacy. Is the dream of determinacy? It is what it is. But we don't have to believe that that's true. We can see through that and say there's no truth to it whatsoever. And so just keep on keeping on here. Other people don't need to understand that, in order for you to give them recognize their freedom. Just because they may disagree with you, that doesn't stop you from recognizing their freedom. They may say, no, I am determinate, but you can say, no, I can see, I realize very clearly, nothing is determinate. No one is, there's no such thing as determinacy. And even your insistence that you're determinate is not determinate. So you cannot change reality. So the world will certainly not agree at all. But that's okay. The fact that we cannot change what we are. So just denying or disagreeing what we are doesn't change it. So we must continue in a positive vein. No, there are no conditions, there are no situations for anyone. Nobody is bound to any situation. There is no bondage, there is no imprisonment whatsoever. And how does one realize that? By extending this truth to all. Because actually, if there's any determinate situation, all is determinate, actually. You cannot have one determinate situation without the entire belief system of determinacy being present. So if you have like someone you think, I hope they stay in this horrible situation and punish them, then you yourself will believe in that horrible situation and punishment. The whole belief system of eternity will engulf you. The clouds will engulf you. So you must extend this indeterminacy, this no situations, no conditions, to everyone without any exception. No single exception whatsoever. And it's not difficult to do. I tend not to try and focus on any particular person or such, but because I just feel, you know, it's easy just to extend it to everybody. Why make any exception? Why single anyone out and say, well, maybe I'm not going to extend it to you or something? Now, of course, it's unequivocal, pure and unequivocal. No one is exempt. There's no exemption, no exception whatsoever. All is indeterminate. Now, you may think there's some terrible person done terrible things. Remember, those so-called victims, there's no conditions or situations for them either. It's all indeterminate for them too. Everyone. So, of course, there's no guilt, actually, which is Jesus' whole teaching. There is no guilt. Since there's no guilt, you know, there's no sin. Since there's no sin, there's no guilt. All is inherently, completely indeterminate. There are no situations or conditions at all. This is Jesus' teaching, and I tend to resonate with this teaching because it's true. It's true. And this is somewhat of a, you know, unique teaching for some reason. For me, it's right on the money, right on the money. It speaks directly to us. So extend it like to everyone, to criminals and to police and to victims and victimizers and, you know, the whole legal system of good and bad and struggling. It's equally extended to all. No sin, no guilt, no conditions, no situations whatsoever. Extend it to the big bankers, the debtors, the loaners, the loan sharks, all the wrong and the right and everything. Now, it's all equally indeterminate. The right just as much as the wrong. It's all total freedom, perfect bliss of indeterminacy. No conditions or situations for anyone. In fact, there's never been. So as far as I know, this is Jesus's message, his position is telling us. Doesn't have a position. Well, he's just saying, what is reality? This is reality. Reality isn't a position, it's what is. It's how all is. And it's backed up by the great recent teachers like Sri Sri Anandamaya Maha, who would say everything is completely perfect. There's absolutely nothing wrong at all, ever. There's nothing going on. What war? She'd say, there's no war. I don't see any war going on at all. I just see dear friends playing a game with one another. Joyously playing a game with one another. This is testimony, you know. Her testimony, to me, completely supports Jesus' teaching, completely supports it. So I'd say, you know, this is important. It's such a witness, giving credible witness to exactly what Jesus' teaching is. There's no sin, there's no guilt, there's no imperfection, there's no wrongs, there's no situations, there's no conditions. All is absolutely perfect, right? Always. Total freedom. Just God. All is God. I am the God. the I am godness is all. This may seem very abstract, but it's if there's no exception to it, so it's completely abstract, completely true. It's not that difficult. We just need to. What's difficult is believing in determinism. We keep thinking, well, I got to figure this out first. I got to be successful with determinism before I, you know, do indeterminism. There is no determinism. How can we be successful with it? It's like saying I need to be successfully deluded before I can be undiluted, not deluded. I need to figure out how to succeed and work with determinism, become very successful. Once I'm really successful with that, then I'll turn my attention to being successful with non-determinism, indeterminism. This is what we do. Amazing, that dream about the cat. The cat's, you know, the body's buried in the ground, but I keep saying to the cat, hey cat, you're still alive, you're alive. I know you, anyone can do it, you can do it, because this cat was the most blissed out creature I've ever seen. This cat was just radiating happiness and bliss. And I said, you know what, why don't you just resurrect yourself? Just resurrect, let us see your resurrection, resurrected body. And then it appeared in light sleep this morning. Wow, it was stunning. But I got it. I said, wow, you did it. You really did it. See, cats are indeterminate too. They're just the I am godness is just as much with them as it is with trees, plants, ground, rocks, sky, water, fire, earth, organisms. All is I am godness. I am totally free, self-released, spontaneous. I am godness. So lo and behold, the cat heard what I was asking. Would you do this for me? I said, ask the cat, would you do this for us? You know, we'd really love to see you again. Would you do this? And it showed up and just flawlessly interacting with us. Now, it's not here in this dream of determinacy. You see, it's not there in this dream of determinacy. But on the awareness that there is no determinacy, it's there. The cat is there. Just as absolutely, you know, purring and just saying, wow, I'm so happy to be here. It's like that, you know, just imagine a cat or any living being that's just saying, I'm so completely blissed out just right here, right now. Just love it, just love it, just love it. Sort of, it picks you up, you know, picks you up. Well, what Jesus said is, just give up any demand for determinacy of form of that, you see. So he says, you can have this experience, but without specifying that it must have this form attached to it. So all real experiencing is of essence and of not a form. Jesus says, you don't need any form at all to be experiencing anything you want to, all experiencing you want to experience. He says, you don't need any form at all. And he says, this is almost impossible for you to understand that right now. Because we think, how can we possibly... It doesn't seem to, you know, believing in determinacy, we think, wow, no, we need the form for the experience. He says, that's not true. But eventually, we'll get to that understanding, eventually. So we just have to realize that there are some clarifications, realizations that we'll eventually get to. But don't get frustrated if we don't quite understand that yet. It's okay, it's fine. Intermediate step here. So, don't give up on truth. Don't give up on truth. It's just beneath the surface. Just beneath the surface. Now, it's frustrating. You think, wow, why doesn't it just surface? You know, Why does it have to be beneath the surface? I'm having these extraordinary dreams. I said, my gosh, if I could just bring this through to have it surface here, oh my gosh, it would be wonderful. This is, but it will. It's gradually wearing away, you know, the continuity fear here. I'm becoming, you know, more and more comfortable with this, more and more comfortable with this. But also it seems kind of slow. So I just have to keep reassuring everyone to stay positive, keep working, keep practicing, full stop in the now, full stop in the wow, full stop in the burn, the consternation, keep bringing up the truth and then let the consternation burn off and melt away, evaporate, evaporate, evaporate. Just keep this evaporation process going and you're thinning out this determinant dream. You're thinning out your attachment to this determinant dream. Okay, in this wonderful indeterminacy, this wonderful freedom, this wonderful blessing for all, is getting closer and closer and closer. It's like the clouds are thinning and the sunlight is getting close. You know, you can see it's like here in the Bay Area we get a lot of fog, and you know, as you're used to, the morning seems real foggy, and you think, oh my gosh, I'm not going to see the sun. Then you realize it's starting to thin out, and before you know it, you know, it's a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful day. It's like that it seems as though the clouds are getting very thin at this point. And there's a little more evaporation, and you realize, oh my gosh, the sky, beautiful, clear sky, the sun is shining. The sun of indeterminacy is now shining, which is the true sun of God. Remember, God extended itself as all. So all is God, all is God. I am the Godness. You are the Godness. This is the Godness. This, that is the Godness. All is the Godness. There's only the Godness. Indeterminate, pure, indeterminate, spontaneous freedom. Which means one moment never determines the next. This moment does not determine the next. The past moments of experiencing do not determine this moment. Each moment, free and clear, to choose any and all experiencing. The ground of being has no preferences, no determinancy of what you have to experience or should experience. There's no shoulds. It's entirely for free. Each moment is total freedom for all. This is the nature of reality, according to the testimony of Jesus Christ, and I believe that testimony. We have to go on faith a little bit, but these inner dreams are showing us like, wow, yeah. Jesus is indeterminate. I mean, that we want to put him in some sort of determinant prison. No, he's indeterminate also. He lives in, Jesus dwells in perfect freedom, indeterminacy also. There's not some form that he's trapped in or experiencing that is trapped in. No, free, completely free, completely free, completely free. So when we say that term, Jesus Christ, people tend to draw in mind images, determinate forms, you know, which kind of shake us up. Like, no, that's not it. That's not it at all. It's the voice of, it's the transmission of truth, the free transmission of truth. Jesus lives today, right now. This indeterminacy is right here, right now. The freedom is right here, right now. So in our day-to-day dream of determinancy, this all seems like a dream, what we're talking about. But remember, it's determinacy is the dream. What we're talking about, we're talking from the position of reality here. So reality is speaking into the dream of determinacy here. So just be aware of your dreams. You know, you have some tremendously positive dreams, and just don't struggle. Don't struggle with it. Just say, hey, this is great. Let's keep on with a tremendous faith that that the clouds will truly evaporate. And I believe that they will. Okay, very great, that's it.